Thank you very much. Hello and welcome on this section. I'm a Hungarian author, a composer, and I will speak about the Libre culture. I will consequently use this new term of copyleft, as Mr. Stelman did on TED conference when he said, Libre is not gratis. Free speech is Libre culture. Libre culture is the culture of humanity, from pre-Solutrean humans via Bach, Goya, Shakespeare, to recent Libre-licensed authors. Indeed, we are using this cultural heritage when we publish our Libre-licensed works, and we are against the monopolization of this cultural heritage, and we want a human copyright system without monopolies and wide restrictions. Scope is the intellectual products, IPs. Every author takes the cultural heritage and remix it to new intellectual products. Think again, Bach, Goya, Shakespeare, and others. The vast majority of intellectual products, IPs, for example, music, movies, literature from comments to romance, are not physical properties, but remixes of the cultural heritage into intellectual products, IPs, which must remain Libre. Meeting of the author's rights and motivations with user rights results Libre culture, what an international copyleft organization can defend. Okay, let's see what are these rights and motivations of authors and users for remix, expression, love, and recognition. Rights to access to the cultural heritage and remix, free speech. Authors have right to be an amateur, act as lover, publish their intellectual products by love, not for more money. They have motivation for recognition by love, attribution, and so on, and or money. The possible good part of the recent over-monopolistic copyright system is the attribution. Via attribution, authors can get more jobs, works, orders easier. Every human has motivation for recognition. Every human has right to express their love without restrictions. Okay, a few examples of non-restricted authors before the Bern Convention from Giotto list. Let's see. Musicians, Perotin the Great, Johann Sebastian Bach, Franz Liszt. They remixed their works freely. Fine art, for example, Giotto, Leonardo da Vinci, Rembrandt, Goya. And in literature, Dante, Shakespeare, and so on. Think Shakespeare works, which comes from the contemporary Italian dramas and so on. He can remix it freely. So they could remix the cultural heritage and got payments for creating a work, not for monopolizing the culture. Very early, more artists resisted against the copyright restrictions. Yes. As Mr. Larry Lessig cited John Milton, old patentees and monopolizers in the trade of book selling, they were men who don't therefore labor in an honest profession. Tolstoy also resisted the copyright restrictions. In music, Terry Riley and other recent authors, composers, have published some works under public domain or Libre licensed. As we say, some rights reversed. SRV. How we get back to some rights reversed and Libre culture concept? Around 1984, Richard Stallman has created the copyleft term, free speech, not free beer. Around millennium, the word Libre appears in the term Libre software, happened in 1994. Then the study of FLOSS published happened in 2001. Later, since 2011 to 2014, LibreOffice implements, it's a good example, LibreOffice implements ISO ODF family standard with many Libre artworks, recognizing developers by attribution and money. Stallman says, Libre is not gratis. Around 2004, the largest Web2 projects have started and de facto broke the copyright monopolies of paper era. Well, today, all netizens are authors. And they can spread the culture of humanity in near equality. This is a Libre word for Libre real cultural competition. Libre culture has appeared on Wikipedia, Wikimedia Commons, and so on. Déclaration universelle des droits de l'homme, Universal Declaration of Human Rights, sorry my weak English and my weak French pronunciation, is the first work on the Wikisource. Let's see some examples about Libre repositories since 2004. Yes. Wikimedia Commons accepts Ogg Vorbis, Speaks and FLAC audio files. Later, since 2008, Wikimedia Commons accepts Theora 1.1 formatted video files. In the art of music, the Mutopia project, the International Music Score Library project, later the Wikimedia Commons accept music score source codes and PDF files. After the Wikimedia Commons has started to accept PDF files, the Gutenberg project and Wikisource also accept music and literature in the standard open source format. Let's see that how the different states accept the copyleft licenses. USA and Canada. The governments are using Creative Commons Zero public domain licenses. European Union. The European Public Sector Information Platform, EPSI, uses Libre licenses, Creative Commons Attribution, and Creative Commons Attribution Share alike. And finally, in Japan, there are many works under CC by SA on the Wikimedia Commons. Japan to reform its copyright system. For example, movies created before 1952 are under Creative Commons Zero license. For example, two of Kurosawa's famous movies, Drunken Angel and Rashomon. Yeah. And finally, our challenges, 2014 and 2015. If we think the case of Saint-Exupéry's Little Prince or Béla Bartók, we have to resist the over-monopolistic copyright system and take for change. We have to organize more internationalized events with non- and for-profit partners, for example, in Hungary, Wikimedia Association, Ustream, and so on. We have to stop Mickey Mouse Act versus human rights cases by 1st January 2016. So, yeah. Sorry? So, we have the constitutional basics to defend the authors' and users' human rights. Hence, therefore, my proposal is to create the International Copyleft Organization, ICLO, for Libre Culture, which later can cooperate with UNESCO, see Free Software Foundation and UNESCO Cooperation, and have to work to defending the Libre Culture. I think we have a good first step to take a declaration defending the Libre Culture, and we can sign a petition with support of a lot of artists and users as first step, preventing next retroactive copyright extension and help defending the Libre Culture on the world. That's all.